Okay. Thank you for tuning in. Hold on to our Morning Glory live video. I'm your host, Dietrich Hubbard. Today we're going to talk about our 2021 State of the Church address. 2021 State of the Church address. Hold on, I got to get rid of this screen so y'all will see me in a minute. I'm trying to everything going wrong today. W-O-U-N-D-E-D. Y'all bear with me. Oh, I see what is wrong. Y'all bear with me. Having technical difficulties for some reason. But it's about to clear up. Because I got to clear this screen before I get to that screen. If not, I'm just gonna have to start it over again. I don't know where, why is it going so slow? All right, I'm having trouble. I'm trying to fix it. Y'all will see me in a minute. It was wrong with technology. They make it easy on one end, it's difficult at another end. For some reason it logged me out, so I got to get back in, and it's going kind of slow. But anyway, that's a bunch of babble. 2021 State of the Church address, and usually what I do, many of you have been following me, every year God will allow me to see certain things within his plan for the coming year. And what happens, come on thing. And what happens is that a lot of people, because they don't understand the goodness of God, they seek and they go after words that doesn't necessarily empower them, but more so they go after words of blessings and miracles and all that other stuff that most of you most of the other stuff you like. Let me type this in so I can log in on Periscope. If it does it, if not, they'll be okay. And so in releasing this word is just to either validate or confirm some of the things that many people sometimes feel in their spirit about what God is going to do. And a lot of times, even teaching the class that we started, a lot of people are clueless in the supernatural things that God allows to happen. And as a result, many fall short in understanding the true definition of what God wants to do on this earth. So these are four things that he gave me, and within these four things, He gave me specific pointers that many of you have to understand if you want to get to that next level in God, because I know, even within myself, a lot of you have felt a intense tug in your spirit, and what happens is that your spirit is searching for more, and when your spirit is searching for more, it begins to wander, because a lot of you are obligated to people, ministry, churches, and spiritual parents, if that's what y'all want to believe. You're obligated to people who sometimes have no clue of what's going on in the spirit realm, nor do they have no clue of what God wants to do in you. So we're just going to go over these four things right quickly, and then I'm going to get out of here. Also, we're bringing the podcast back. I already got it up on Spotify. We're waiting on iTunes, Pandora, and iHeartRadio, because God told me that was one of the main platforms that I had that would allow me to reach a lot of people, and I haven't done it in quite a year, so we got to bring that back. But we will be going on all the major platforms, the iTunes, Spotify, Pandora, iHeartRadio. So y'all look for that when it starts. Matter of fact, I'm around here fooling with all this equipment trying to get it together. But it is what it is. The first thing God says is that we're going to have to covenant. He said covenant. And what it is, a lot of you are not aware of what you're in covenant with. And a lot of you are not in covenant with anybody. You running from church to church to leader, and you're looking for something. And what you're looking for, you're not going to get it till you get stable. So in 2021, a lot of you needs to become in covenant with somebody. And when I mean in covenant, you got to learn how to stick with people through the good and the bad. You got to learn how to stick with people whether they're going down or whether they're going up. But a lot of you just want to hang around people when the going gets good. And what that does, it shows that you're not that you can't be trusted, is one word we're going to use. But it also shows that you have no loyalty. So in 2021, God said he's looking for people with loyalty. And within that loyalty, he said you got to be consistent in your loyalty. See, I understand why a lot of people would rally around, especially with the stuff that's going on with Brian Karn and Matthew Stevenson and Jamal Bryan. You've listened to these people so long, and when they fall, you automatically think that you're supposed to stick with them, and you do to a certain point. But when something becomes a pattern, when something becomes a habit, and they show no remorse, because see, the word repentance means to turn from. So if you've been listening to people who have a pattern of falling. They have a pattern of sleeping around. They have a pattern of having all these babies out of wedlock. Then that's time for you to change. So God is looking for consistency in this season. Because when you find or come in covenant with somebody, you're going to be consistent in certain parts of your life. Because one thing God wants to do with a lot of y'all got to find your niche in this season. And what I mean by niche, you got to find your position. A lot of you just going to church. A lot of you treating church, ministry, or whatever you're doing, your YouTubing and you treating that as a cycle. You may hear a word of God. You may be dedicated to these people, but you're not growing. It's like. I ain't got nothing around me. I take for instance, I bought a watch the other day. I thought it was a Victor, but I wasn't looking correctly. So it said Invictus. And then when I order it and they sent me the tracking number, and I looked at it, I said, hey, that coming from China. That must be bootleg, because anytime I buy something from a Victor, it comes there. So I really just didn't pay attention until I got it yesterday. And when I got the watch and I looked at it, because all Invictus had a name on it, it didn't have Invicta name on it. And what you trying to teach me, Brother Hubbard? A lot of you, God don't have his name on you because you around people because of popularity, but they're not your, they are not assigned to you, is what I'm going to see. See, we got to be wary of going to people because of name recognition. They got a big following. See, a lot of y'all lost in the crowd. That's what happened in the Bible when we talk about Barabbas and Jesus and Barabbas and everybody follow Barabbas. But only a few follow Jesus. But the few that follow Jesus, guess what they got? They got power. They got authority. They went toward their destiny. But the ones that followed Barabbas, they just went with the crowd. So God's trying to tell you the reason he wants you to become in covenant with somebody. Are you, think to yourself, am I following the crowd or am I following Christ? Because if you've been sitting under any kind of teaching of a leader, whether it's in a church, whether it's a mentor, whether it's an apostle, y'all know how I feel about that spiritual parent. That ain't of God. And y'all need to get in your head it ain't of God. Because that big old stuff going on down with Matthew Steves and them little friends down in Atlanta, that shows you the error in what you're doing. Because he looks at this man as a spiritual parent, as a spiritual father, and he looked at him as a spiritual son, and you take them out of Arizona, wherever they're from, put them in a church in Atlanta, and put all this, but 4 years later, because of whatever happened, you done took that weight from you. See, one thing we got to understand, whatever comes for God, don't bring sorrow. God is not an Indian giver. So how can this man say, God told me to give you this? See, what happened, this man is taking people and putting it under his ministry name or his umbrella, which means if you don't function the way he wants you to function, then you can't function at all. That's not of God. See, y'all got to, it's deeper than what most people think when it comes to finding a person who really understands how God worked in the spirit as well as the natural. Because one thing about, if you were son of God, God ain't going to fire you. God ain't going to, he'll chastise you, but he's not going to take something away from you. So a lot of you got to get in your mind, am I where God want me to be in this season? And this is the message for the church. I forgot to put it out. He said, 21 the state of the church address should have been, are you in position? Because see, a lot of you running behind T.D. Jakes, you running behind Juanita Bynum, you running behind Brian Carr, you running behind anybody with a nationwide platform, but you don't have no independent growth. Anybody can get behind a platform, say this is what God says, and you go to shaking and hollering and slobbing and bucking and, oh, preach, pastor, preach. But the independent growth, a lot of time when I'm out preaching in engagements and I finish and a lot of people come back and they say the same thing. She said, they'll say, when you up there preaching, I can actually see what you're saying in my head. Which means when I give examples or when I say something, they can see it formally. See, that's when you know the spirit work, because the spirit is talking to a spirit. So if I'm speaking spiritually and you can see what's going on in my head, that's God putting the plan together for you. See, a lot of you got to find your position because you behind. You done went to this church and the pastor didn't know who you are. You done went to this church and the pastor didn't know who you are. You done went to this leader that told you are. You done went to this prophet. You done went to this prophet. Some of y'all like the woman with the issue of blood. You bleeding trying to get to Jesus, but don't nobody know how to stop the bleeding. The only thing going to stop the bleeding this season, find the person that is assigned to you. And that's very key when I get to the end, that you understand you got to find people who are assigned to you. You can't go to a church or to a prophet or whatever because you like the way they dress. You like the clothes they wear. You like the big pretty language they use. They got a children's church. Your friend go there. Your boyfriend go there. Your girlfriend go there. That's your mama church. You've been there for 20 years. If you're going to growth take movement, you can't grow sitting in the same spot. I was talking to an apostle down out of Birmingham yesterday who was talking about growth. And she was giving me a revelation. I said, yeah, that's kind of what God told me. He said, learning me is like going to class. You got to know when it's time to pass class so you can graduate. Some of y'all been in ministry, but you never ministering. You'll go get a little word, and if they don't do it the way you think it ought to be done, you're gone. That's why I say you got to sit there through the good and the bad. The next thing, when you find that person who understands your position and going to take you to that position, you got to be faithful. A lot of y'all get into a little mishap or misunderstanding, or you don't understand what they doing, and boom, you gone. Listen here. Ministry comes with confrontation. So if you subscribe to this, I want all positive people around me, you ain't ready for ministry. All positive people went around Christ, but didn't Christ finish his work? Did he say it is finished? Did Apostle Paul say, I did what I had, just to paraphrase, I did what I had to do, I finished my course? Because Apostle Paul knew his time was up. See, one thing about Christ, and if we're going to be Christ-like, if a person fall, they fall. But if a person consisted in falling, then you got to watch that person. Because what's happening is a lot of people in ministry that's more sinners than they are saints. So you don't want to be around a person that's more sinner than a saint, because they're not going to hear God because they're in their flesh. The second thing God has to do, and that's why I said you got to find covenant, you got to find your connection. Your connection is not saying touch three people. Your connection is not saying, well, pastor won $2,400 this month for his anniversary. Your connection is not going to buy these prayer cloth. Your connection connects you to Christ. Your connection in this season has to be validated in three areas. That's why I say you got to find somebody to be in covenant with, because your connection is important. The three areas are spiritual, which means you got to find a leader. See, watch this. How can you say this church, a place your church home, or this your leader, this your prophet, this your apostle, and they don't know what's going on with you? It's no spiritual connection. I don't care how people feel about what I say. But if Eddie Long was down there screwing all them boys for that long, and T.D. Jakes didn't know, it wasn't no spiritual connection. If Jamal Bryant around here screwing all these women for this long, whoever his overseer is now, it ain't no spiritual connection. See, you can't have a spiritual connection and they only tell you what God gonna do for you. They gotta tell you when you're wrong. See, a lot of you been in religion so long, you don't want correction. Correction is part of ministry. If you don't want to be corrected, what does the Bible say? You a bastard. And that's what's wrong. We got a lot of bastard spirit preaching. from the throne of God, but actually they manipulating God's word to get what they want out of you. Spiritual. You got to find somebody who got a spiritual connection. You know, I say it all the time. The few people that I'm mentoring now or whatever, if something wrong with them, they know I pick up the phone. I say, hey, what you doing? Or I send that old frowny face that I've seen. Or I send that thinking face. Because why? I'm not trying to tell you how to live your life, but when you're going down a path and it's not leading to God, somebody has to intervene. So watch this. How can you be part of a ministry for 5, 10, 20 years and you screwing everything that got a hole? Or you got your legs up for every man that got a few dollars. And your leader knows nothing about it. Something wrong. Because how can you grow spiritually if the sin is not confronted? Naturally, you got to have a natural connection to your connection. And see, what's a natural connection? A natural connection is just like Christ did the people. If your leader too good to come to your house, too good to sit around and eat with you, that ain't your leader. See, we miss the little thing that Christ did. Christ sat there and ate with sinners, prostitutes, adulterers, liars, thieves, backstabbers. Why? Because he seen the good in them even when they didn't see it in themselves. I remember going to a church in Birmingham and we did this little birthday party for this leader at this time, and they had the audacity to say, I don't eat with everybody. Oh, you know it wasn't too long after I left. See, watch this. How can you think you are better than people if you're trying to empower people? I never think I'm better than people. When people say, Brother Hubbard, come on my house, I'm coming. If the roach is crawling, they just crawling. If your house nasty, it's nasty. Now, one thing I ain't gonna put up with now, I ain't gonna put up with that one ply toilet paper. I need double ply, cause I ain't finna see some of that one ply toilet paper okay. But I don't want that toilet paper that when I reach back there to wipe my butt is a handful of on it. Get some real toilet paper if you're gonna invite me now. Cause watch this. We coming, which means if I got to eat there, I might have to take me a dump. And at least let me have some good toilet paper. See, leaders been taught to not fraternize with the sheep. They say don't become common in the sheep. But ain't that what Jesus did? Jesus has to become. Why do you have to, as a leader, let me tell you this. You have to be common with the people that you're leading, because not to be common with them, it says you're more than them. The Bible teaches everybody is the same. You might have more spiritual authority than that. Because see, I hate when I go to a church and preach and somebody invited me and I can stand there and I can look on the pew and I can see the people on the pews more annoying than the person that's behind the pulpit. And you know why? It's because that person behind the pulpit see themselves as more than anybody else. See, they done taught you can't go no higher than your leader. But didn't Elijah go farther than Elijah? Didn't Christ tell the disciples greater works that you gonna do? Don't the Bible say it's not robbery to be equal with God? Doesn't the Bible say we made in his image and his likeness? Which means your leader is not the epiphany of Christ. Christ is. And the epiphany of Christ is God. Which means your leader shouldn't be telling you can't go no higher than them. Because they're not the mark, is what I meant to say. They're not the mark of Christ. God is. So anything I ever done, they taught me that. But I thought for myself. I heard about God said that ain't right. He said, I'm the mark of ministry. When a person tells you you can't go high, no higher than them, watch this. You stagnate your anointing because they're not the mark. God is the mark. I never tell a person you can't go no higher than me. I got people that I mentor now do things higher than what I do. But watch this. When they can't understand something, they come back down to me. When I can't understand something, watch this. I go up to them. You see this? Do you see that exchange? Because as a leader, you got to realize some of the people that you lead are more anointed than you. But if you're teaching people you can't go no higher than your leader, you stagnated them because so now they think you the epiphany of ministry. Natural. The third thing, financial. How can you be in covenant with somebody? How can you be connected with somebody and you don't support them? Ministry costs money. Let's get this straight. Now, a lot of you been burnt by people who that's all they want is your money. A lot of you been burnt by these false prophets with these money lines. The Bible said don't give under compulsion, which means when you run to a money line because the prophet said you got to sow $100, that's compulsion. The Bible also says don't give to somebody else that their burden may be lessened, but yours is weightier. That's just a prophet, a paraphrase. It's in there somewhere. So you got to understand, support, watch this. This is my rule of thumb. If you know somebody to help you grow spiritually, if you know somebody to help you grow naturally, the least thing you can do to say, well, God, how can I help their ministry financially? And it ain't got to be financial all the time. God, how can I help their ministry? What you know how to do? A lot of people that can't give Brother Hubbard no money, you know what they say? They say, Brother Hubbard, want me to do a video thing for you? Now, I know how to do my own video, but certain things I get tired of, but they got a gift for that. I say, yeah, go ahead and do that, handle that for me. So what I'm saying, sort of support them financially, what I'm saying, if it's not money, God, what can I do? And see, one thing I like about God, when God called me into ministry, he said, I'm going to teach you everything that you need to know about ministry. I know how to run my own podcast. I'd have had my own TV show. I ran that, did the videos and all that. I know how to do my own website. I know how to do my own logo. I know how to print my own shirt. And you know the reason why? Because God said, he said, people find it. He said, I don't want you to be in a position that when people don't like what you say or they convict about what you say, that if they're doing something for you, they leave and you can't do nothing. See, a lot of y'all need people. Brother Hubbard don't need you. I know how to do it all. Thank God I know how to do it all. The third thing God says in this 2021, you got to find your authority. If your identity is just connected to a church, a person, or people, then you don't know who you are. God said he wants to see your authority in this season. So what you got to ask yourself, who am I? Yeah, I know you're a child of God, but God's saying, who are you? Which means, why did I put you on this earth? Then you got to ask yourself, what is my authority? I mean, come on now. What's your authority? Which means, what's your gift? What's your calling? What's your authority that God gave you to take on these demons on this earth, to take on these spirits, to take on these people, to show his power in you? What did God give you? If your leader if your overseer, if your spiritual parent, if your apostle, if your mentor can't tell you, and not only tell you, can't empower you, you have the wrong connection. Because in this season, God said, he said, where is my power? I said, what you mean by that? He said, where's my power? Y'all perfected dressing good. You perfected praise and worship. You perfected how to give, but you ain't perfected in Christ. Where is my power? He wanna see what he gave you demonstrated on this earth. I say it all the time. If you never had a one-on-one with your leader, and he talked to, and he told you about your strength, he or she, or them, because some of y'all got more than one, if they never told you about your strength, your weakness, your calling, your gifting, your anointing, your life, that's not a leader from God. Because God is not going to allow you to sit in a place and not know who you are. When people come around me, when I be in the church buildings or in the conference room where I'm at, and I'm having service, and they in front of me for more than a month, and God don't speak to them, I go tell them. I say, hey, I don't think you belong here, or you're not supposed to get here yet, because God has not said nothing to me about you. Let me tell you about real leadership. Real leadership do not cater to pew puppets. What that means is that I don't want you because you might like what I'm talking about. You like what I'm teaching. If God is not speaking to me about you, you're not my assignment. See, a lot of y'all got, with this message here, a lot of y'all will sit, my pastor ain't never did me like that. That's leadership. That's the basic core leadership. Basic core leadership.